Welcome to Community Focus. Today, our guest on the program is Neal Parks. He is an author and also a paranormal researcher, investigator, a public speaker, and also a world traveler. Neal, thanks for taking a few minutes to chat with us today.
Sure. Thank you for the invite.
Sounds like you lead a pretty interesting life.
Oh, yeah, you could say that.
First of all, you were born in Chillicothe. You still make your home there?
Yeah, I've lived in Chillicothe since 2000, but I was raised in the Waverly Beaver area, a small little village called Gibbons.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're very familiar with that. Tell us a little bit about yourself, first off.
Well, I'm an award-winning author and a lifelong artist, and I sort of harnessed that medium within the art field of literature and have incorporated some of my more artistic art within the books themselves as far as photography and sketches go. I try to use a lot of illustrations to keep it interesting so it's not just all words and no guff, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
I have appeared in several documentaries and have been credited in different major motion pictures and television documentaries. I've helped in major documentaries and have appeared in interviews on Fox 28 News, ABC 6, 10TV, and more recently, Loper and Randy in the Morning on 99.7 The Blitz in Columbus.
Okay.
They featured me in October for the more or less like a Halloween-themed month they were going for. They had me in every other week.
Yeah.
That was a lot of fun.
Yeah. What got you interested in paranormal activity?
I would have to credit that to my grandmother. She shared a lot of really interesting and out-of-this-world stories from her childhood when she was growing up in southeastern Kentucky, Salyersville, I believe it was called.
Mm-hmm.
And stories that she had experienced herself or had been told by her grandparents and other relatives that have experienced things. So it just sort of followed her around, and she bestowed that upon me, and I had a real interest in classic horror movies like Dracula and Frankenstein, the works of Edgar Allan Poe, and anything Vincent Price was in. So I just really got sucked into that genre and enjoyed reading about it, writing about it my own way. Decided in 2008 to try and test the waters with a book, and four books later and one literary award, it's not a bad hobby.
Absolutely. Well, we want to talk a little bit about the books. You went to Ohio University, and you have your own research team and have conducted several investigations. Tell us about that.
Oh, goodness. I've been to Salem, Massachusetts, Bar Harbor, Maine, Boston, Gettysburg, which is a phenomenal hot spot for any kind of paranormal activity.
Hmm.
Chillicothe, for example, and Waverly have their own legends and folklore and mythology and haunted locations. The Emmett House, God rest its soul, was one location I had been to on many occasions. And there was a lot of rich history to that, both in the house itself and even underneath it.
Yeah.
Parts of the canal going through these old towns
Yeah.
have a lot of history and high energy that you can just sort of tap into when you're there.
Hmm. Any one particular spot stand out above all others that you've investigated?
The Majestic Theater. You can always hear something, feel something, or see something when you go there, whether it be inside the walls of that building or even along the alleyway, which is known as Blood Alley.
Right.
Another one, which was one of the first places that started me on this, was the Emmett House, which no longer stands. But,
right.
A lot of really interesting occurrences took place in that building.
Any other locations here in Waverly or Pike County you've investigated?
The Pavilion area at Lake White.
Okay.
that area, there is said to be a, when there was a campground there many years ago, there was a girl gathering wood, and she tripped and fallen forward and was burned alive. And there are people that say when you're walking that area late at night, you can feel someone's hands grab onto your pant legs and pull you in one direction.
Hmm.
So she had her hands filled with wood. She fell forward, got knocked out, and was burned alive, unfortunately. So her ghost is said to roam that picnicking area.
Hmm.
There's also allegedly ghosts of people who've drowned in Lake White that you can see or hear people splashing and calling out for help, and there's no one there.
Hmm. Now, you've been a guest speaker at, as you mentioned there a few minutes ago, at several different locations. You were at Mothman Festival, the Mid-Ohio Paranormal Convention, and you've also even appeared at some schools and churches, correct?
That is correct, yeah. Libraries, schools, churches. Every year around October, they always have me coming and tell ghost stories to kids during the Halloween dance.
Well,
I've done speaking to classrooms of creative writing and so forth in high school. I've conducted that as well.
Yeah, most recently you were at Northside Library reading excerpts from the Christmas Carol.
Christmas Carol.
Yeah. Your first book was, Paranormal Chronicles, Tales of Humor, Horror, and the Absolutely Strange. Tell us about that book.
Wow, that was, like I mentioned earlier, it's just a way for me to test the water to see if anyone would actually buy a book written by me. And that was 10 years ago that one was released. And since then, I've written Haunted Chillicothe, Haunted Holidays, which won a literary award in 2014, and most recently, my newest book is called Haunted Enough, with a question mark at the end, kind of a play on punctuality, but it's sort of a way to let you know that I'm not finished yet, but at the same time, you're thinking, oh, come on, another haunted book? Question mark. Trying to have fun with it.
All right. And the as you mentioned, that's your newest, your fourth release, correct?
Yes.
The books, of course, we've got the bookstore there in Chillicothe. Are the books available there and online as well?
Yeah, they're available at Weedbury Books, and you can also order them on Amazon. You can get them through Barnes & Noble. You can get them through booksnow.com or lulu.com.
Again, our guest on the program today, Neal Parks, author of Haunted Holidays. That is his fourth and current book. Also the winner of the 2014 Paranormal Awards. Tell us about your time there. As I mentioned, you were a guest speaker at Mothman Festival. That's a pretty good sized festival, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It grows more and more each year, and I've been a guest speaker there since off and on since 2008. I haven't appeared there as a guest speaker in the last 2 years because I've been focusing on other festivals and conventions around, but I plan on returning this year, especially since my new book, Haunted Enough, was just released in May. So I'll be hitting that circuit again in September. That's the plan for now.
Okay. And as we mentioned, you've got your own research team. You want to talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, it's primarily my wife and I and her brother and his wife. We have about four or five other on-again, off-again assistants that help us with photography, camera work, using the equipment such as infrared thermometers, thermal imaging cameras, electromagnetic field meters, dowsing rods. What we do is we go into a location, we feel it out without equipment first, and then we come back with equipment to see if what we're feeling can be verified scientifically with the equipment that measures such phenomenon.
And how do you decide? You get invites from folks, or how does that process work of you deciding where you're going to go to investigate paranormal activity?
Well, for the longest time, we would do primarily commercial properties. We did a few, quite a few, in fact, private properties, but the liability risk in that is not worth the cost. Plus, you don't really know what you're getting into when it's someone's private residence.
Right.
Could it be faked? Could it be them just wanting closure on something and they demand that you declare it haunted? Run into quite a few cases like that where people are looking for ghosts, but they just don't happen to be there. It's something going on personally in their lives, and these things are manifesting in that form, and they're thinking that it's something paranormal, but it's all psychological. So we've avoided private properties for that reason. Plus, we all have kids at this point, this far into the game, and we don't really want to expose ourselves to any kind of negative energy and have it attach itself to us and then bring it home and then it possesses our children's toys. Not worth the risk. So we stick primarily, when we do investigations, at commercial properties.
Of course, with paranormal activity, there's those that, you know, you have the naysayers out there. What would you say to them that would maybe convince them otherwise?
Well, one point I've had to defend constantly is I'm very active in my church. We all are, in fact, very grounded in our Christian faith. And a lot of people that are more on the far right side who want to ignore those things or consider it all a demon and angel, I just have to bring up the fact that nothing is more paranormal or supernatural than the birth, life, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, and or the creation of God and what he did himself. Nothing's more supernatural than that. So those things are like stacked chips. They all fall in line like a domino effect, trickle down. One thing led to another. And I'm certain God didn't tell us everything. He does not want us to share the same level of intelligence and continuity that he does. So I'm sure he left a lot of things out from original scripture and the guidebook to life, basically.
Right.
Because we don't need to know everything.
Right. Is there any one or two places that you have not investigated that you would like to?
Would absolutely love to investigate all of Europe, but that's just not in the budget. But my wife and I are planning a trip, leisure trip to Europe, some point in the next 5 years. And we will be hitting a lot of places in London, a lot of places in Ireland. That's the plan. And we'll see where it takes us from there. As far as the states, places that I've not been but would love to go to and explore would have to be places out west. Like the Alamo, for example, would be a great stop. The Caged Bird Theater at an old west ghost town that's been completely renovated and open to the public is a touring ground. I believe that's out in Arizona. I would love to see that. Just to explore some of these old places that we've not made it to.
How about, of course, when you think of paranormal activity, the Waverly Sanitarium is always comes to mind. Is that some place that you've investigated or a place you'd like to?
Waverly Hill Sanitarium is definitely on our to-do list. Which, unfortunately, is not located in Waverly, Ohio, but all the way out in Kentucky. A bit of a drive. It's almost 2 hours. We've not made it there yet, but that is one place that is top-notch on our list to go to.
And, of course, there's an old prison, I believe, in West Virginia that's said to be very active as well.
Yeah, prisons are, I'm really leery about going to prisons because the darkest of the dark existed there in life. And where does it go once that person dies or is executed and then dies?
Yeah.
It just hangs out and bakes itself into the wall. So it's waiting for people to come in. So the dark entity can mess with you. and possibly lead those that are more nimble-minded down a dark path.
Right.
So we try to avoid darkness on every level.
Again, our guest is Neal Parks, and Neal's newest book, his fourth release, Haunted Enough, Terrifying Tales to Your Friends, Paranormal Chronicles. Anything new in the works, Neal?
I'm currently working on an actual novel, because everything else I've written has been a series, a collection of short stories. And an actual novel is what I'm working on. Not going to give too many details about it, but it will be very reminiscent of the TV show Stranger Things mixed with Goonies, with a slight pinch of the X-Files taking place in a local venue that we'll all be familiar with.
Okay. I'm
trying to tie everything in.
Are you still hosting your own show, Paranormally Speaking? Is that still active?
Once in a while, I try to do it monthly. I was doing weekly, then I had to change it to bi-weekly, and now I'm doing once a month setup where I post something new pertaining to what I've got going on. I try to throw in an interview with someone and do something out in the field and show how to or what I'm doing currently. So yeah, I still keep that active and post something new once a month.
Okay, Neal Parks, author, paranormal researcher, investigator, public speaker, and world traveler. Again, the book's available at Wheatberry Books in Chillicothe and online as well.
Yes, it is.
All right, Neal, thanks for taking a few minutes to chat with us. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much for your time.